Let's face it, you have a nice rigged 3D character ready for use in your Godot game, but it still looks so dull. If you really want to bring your character to life, you're going to need facial animations. But that sounds like a pain, right? It is, if you're going to do a full face rig. Luckily though, you don't need that for a video game. While it's still a bit tedious, I'll show you just how easy it is to make facial animations for a character, and we can see them pay off in the Godot engine too. And the cool part? What you learn here sets you up for facial mocap down the road, even if all you want right now is some simple smiles. So how do we face this challenge? Using shape keys, of course. Shape keys are essentially different states that you can put your model in, which Blender can blend between. For example, I could make a state where my character's eyes are closed, then blend between that and the base model to get this result. You may have also heard of them being called blend shapes, which is what Godot calls them, or morph targets in other engines. But why shape keys? Shape keys serve as a good starting place for making facial animations, as we can use sculpt mode or edit mode to make them, and it's a lot quicker and easier than making a full face rig. With that said, are you now ready to make your first shape key? I will walk you right through the process. We'll make the eyebrow go slightly downward, sort of like a squint. It's really easy to do, too. In Blender, with your model selected, navigate to the Object Data Properties tab, typically on the far right side of the screen. Here you should see a section for shape keys. Expand it and click the plus button to create the basis key. The basis key is just your model's base position, as all other shape keys will transform it relative to this position. Click the plus button again, and you should now have a new key. Call this one brow down left, exactly as I have it named, for later, and then set the value to 1. Also make sure the brow down left key is selected. Then in edit mode, or sculpt mode, if you prefer, grab the proportional edit tool and grab the tip of the character's eyebrow on your right side, which is their left side. Move it down slightly, taking care not to distort the eye too much. It's okay if you distort it a little, as the reference we'll use later does. When you're done, exit edit mode, and now you can see your shape key work by moving the value slider back and forth. Congrats! You made your first shape key, now just 51 more to make. But I will explain. There's a nice little standard called ARKit, which describes facial motion in 52 different shape keys. It's commonly used for facial motion capture, as mocap software can track facial movements and map them back to the 0-1 values on each of the 52 keys. It was developed by Apple of all people, even though I thought it would be an Adobe thing. But aren't 52 shape keys a lot? Yes, it is. But we technically don't need to make that many, since a good portion of them are mirrors of each other. Of course, as we go, you are welcome to skip the keys you don't foresee needing for your game. But first, don't bite your tongue too quickly now. We have to make your character's teeth and tongue meshes. The teeth and the tongue aren't used per se by the 52 shape keys, but they will be visible when your character's mouth opens. The good news is that they are very easy to make, and they can be low poly too. For the tongue, all I really did was duplicate a face from my character's face and reapplied the mirror modifier. Then I joined it together, extruded it a few times, and moved it inside her mouth. I also resized it appropriately to fit inside her mouth. For the teeth, I duplicated the tongue and removed all but one face. Here I extruded once to give it thickness and then moved it into place. I further extruded on the sides, taking care to follow the contours of her mouth from the top view. Finally, I duplicated the teeth one more time to make the bottom set, and moved both into place. Don't worry if you get the positioning wrong, it can always be readjusted later. With the tongue and the teeth out of the way, we can get to the fun part, making the shape keys. Like I said earlier, while there's 52 we have to make, technically we only need to make 32. The other 20 are mirrors, such as the I blink L and the I blink R keys. I'll walk you through exactly how to make each one, so feel free to sift through this section of the video to find the ones you're looking for. Let's begin by hiding any hair or accessories around the head, so that you have the head as the only thing visible. That way you do not mess up anything else while you work. I also recommend making sure your character's expression is in a neutral pose. It should look something like mine, where the mouth is flat and the eyebrows aren't raised. This will help later, as there are keys that will have your character smiling and shaping the mouth. Now we can finally walk through the shape keys. In the description, I have a link to a really helpful guide on what each of the 52 shape keys are supposed to morph. I recommend having that guide open while you work on them, if you are able to follow along with what I have. Make sure to also name the shape keys exactly as I have them. If you ever want to do facial mocap, they need to have matching names. Starting with the brow down right key, we can simply mirror the brow down left key we have from earlier. To mirror the key, click on the brow down left key, then hit this little arrow and select duplicate shape key. Then with the new key selected, hit the arrow again and hit mirror shape key. Test that it's working on your model. If your model's face is asymmetrical, you may have to make the key from scratch, just like we did before. Brow inner up is interesting as it's one key for both eyebrows. To make this one, enter sculpt mode, set the X mirror to on, and use the grab brush to drag the middle area between the eyebrows upwards. Brow outer up left is like the last key, but this time just the left eyebrow. Using the grab brush in sculpt mode, turn off the X mirror and move the outer tip of the eyebrow upwards and slightly out. Brow outer up right is just a mirror of the last key. Use the same process as before to duplicate and mirror the key. Eye blink left is easier done in edit mode, as we want to hide the eye and not disturb the other parts of the face as much. Select the eye on the left side and press H to hide it. Then with proportional editing turned on, select the inner loop of the eye and press S, Z, and 0 to flatten it. You'll have to smooth the vertices around the eyelash and the eyelid a bit, but if you have the smooth vertices mapped to a hotkey like I do, it's easy. Again, eye blink right is a mirror of eye blink left. So work your magic. Eye look down left can be done by moving the eyelid downward slightly, then taking the eye object in edit mode and moving that down too. Since my model doesn't have a real eye per se, I simulate the rotation by moving it and then rotating it slightly. If you have a spherical eye, you could just rotate it on its axis. Yet again, eye look down right is just a mirror. You know what to do. Eye look in left is very similar to eye look down left, in that you would be moving and rotating the eye inside. Use the axis locks while rotating to help you. Also, don't let the potential creepiness factor weird you out on this one. You guessed it, this one is a mirror. Eye look out left is just like eye look in left, just the other way. Move the eye to the outside and rotate it to face the outside more as well, taking care not to have the eye object jut out of the socket. Mirror. Eye look up left is pretty much the same thing as the other ones we just did recently. Technically, on the reference, the eyelid moves up a bit, which I could have done here using sculpt mode, but I didn't feel like it. Mirror. Eye squint left is easily done in sculpt mode. Make sure to hide the eyes in edit mode first so you don't mess them up. Then just use a grab brush and move the bottom eyelid up some. Yet another mirror. Eye wide left can also be done efficiently in sculpt mode. Use the grab brush once again and pull the top of the eyelid up some. Cross-reference the eye to check your alignment with the reference. Don't worry if you distort the eyebrow a little here. It'll add some artistic effect anyway. Mirror the key for the umpteenth time. The jaw forward key. We'll have to do a little prep work as this one's a bit of a pain otherwise. We'll go into edit mode and isolate the upper lip and then make a vertex group that only selects the upper lip. I did this by selecting one of those lip loops, pressing Ctrl plus and pressing Shift H to hide everything but. Then I selected the middle edge loop between the top lip and the bottom lip and hid that. Then I used the L key to select the top of the lip. After that, assign it to a new vertex group by pressing the plus button by the vertex group option and clicking assign. For the key itself, I unhid everything with Alt H, selected the upper lip group we just made, and then hid the upper lip. Now you can go into sculpt mode, enter side view, and use the grab 2D brush to move the lower jaw forward. For the jaw left key, with the upper lip still hidden, use the grab 2D brush to move the lower jaw and lip to the side. Note, the grab 2D brush works a bit better on moving the whole silhouette than the regular grab brush, but feel free to use what works for you. If I had a nickel for every time I said the word mirror, I'd have a lot of nickels. For the jaw open key, hide the upper lip, the neck, the teeth, and the tongue, and use sculpt mode to move the bottom of the mouth and chin downwards. Use the smooth tool and sculpt mode to smooth out the rough parts. You want the jaw to make roughly an O shape. Once you have the jaw roughly where you want it, you can unhide the upper lip and then smooth it around the edges to make the mouth look more appealing. Don't forget to also move the teeth and the tongue into place. You may notice that the normals are messed up here, but don't worry, we'll fix that after we're done making the shape keys. The mouth close key is the weirdest one, as it's relative to the jaw open and not the basis key. To work with this, you'll need to first open the jaw completely. Then click the arrow and select New Shape from Mix before making this key. Then with the new key, find the Relative 2 dropdown and select Jaw Open. To edit the key, I moved the jaw up a little bit in sculpt mode, then I swapped to edit mode, selected the inside loop of the mouth, and used proportional editing to flatten it like we did with the eye blink, pressing S, Z, and then 0. Lastly, I smoothed the mouth out a bit in sculpt mode to make it look nicer. For mouth funnel, you'll want to first hide the upper lip, the teeth, and the tongue. Then move the bottom of the mouth down a bit. I unhid the upper lip once again and just sculpted it upwards. It'll affect the teeth, but that's okay as long as the upper teeth are showing in the final product. I also spent some time closing the edges of the mouth a little. Mouth pucker is real easy, so you shouldn't puck this one up. From the side view, in sculpt mode, just drag both lips forward a bit and have them line up a bit more than usual. Also, from the front, move the corners of the lips closer to the center. All you need to do for mouth left is use the grab brush to move the mouth toward the left side. You can move the whole mouth. We haven't had a mirror in a while, so here's a good one. Turn that frown upside down and use the grab brush again to move the left corner of the mouth. You don't need to move the whole mouth this time. Just move the corner and exaggerate it to your liking. For daintier characters, you may not want to widen the mouth as much. Mirror the mouse smile left key like the many other keys you've mirrored so far. Turn that smile upside down and do the frown similar this time around. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Why am I so sad? Mouth dimple left looks like mouse smile left, but it's a bit more inside the face. This one is simply done in sculpt mode and with the grab brush. If your character is stylized, you may want to exaggerate it more to tell the look apart from a regular smile. Mirror this one just like the others. Mouth stretch left is similar to the last key, except it's closer to a frown than a smile. Use sculpt mode again and pull the lip down and out a bit. Feel free to exaggerate this one a bit as well. Mouth stretch right is a mirrored last key, so mirrored it the same way as the others. For mouth roll lower, hide the essentials again and using sculpt mode with X mirror on, move the lower lip back with the grab 2D brush. For mouth roll upper, I took the time to make a vertex group that selects the lower mouth. I did this similarly to how we made the one for the upper lip earlier, by hiding things around it until I could isolate the lower lip. Then I used sculpt mode to move the upper lip in from the side. You may need to move the teeth and the tongue inside some more too. This one is pretty easy. Hide the upper lip, the teeth, and the tongue, and then move the lower lip up forward from the side view. This one may seem similar to mouth funnel we did a while back, but it's just for the upper lip. Hide the lower lip and the teeth, then move the upper lip in sculpt mode. Unhide the teeth and position them similar to what I have. You may have to scale the teeth to match the reference too. This one is very easily done by using the proportional editing in edit mode, as you can select near the mouth and scale down to make it look like it's pressing in. Remember to turn off the X mirror if you haven't done so already. It's that time again. Mirroring time. The mouth lower down left key can be made pretty much the same way as many of the other keys. Hide the upper lip, the teeth, and the tongue, and use proportional editing or sculpt mode to move just the side portion of the lower lip down. Realign the teeth as needed. It's mirroring time, again. This one is done just like the mouth lower down left, except you hide the bottom lip instead of the top one, and you move the side of the top lip upwards. Just two more mirrors after this one. Cheek puff can be done with the inflate brush in sculpt mode. For this one, it applies to both sides, so enable X mirror. It may help to also toggle the viewport shading to solid to see your character's contours if you're using a toon shaded look like mine. For cheek squint left, I did this one in edit mode. I hit the eye and used proportional editing to move the cheek up. You're moving the bottom eyelid by design with this one, so make sure that it gets adjusted alongside the cheek movement. This is the second to last mirror, and now we're moving on to the second to last key. For the semi-file shape key, you'll move the left tip of the nose upward and the tip of the eyebrow down, taking care not to disturb the eye. Use any of the tools we've learned about here. Here I chose to use proportional editing, but sculpt mode is also valid. For the final shape key, it's just a mirror. Yay, you're all done! After all that hard work, let's make an animation with the shape keys. For this example, I'll take an existing animation and add some facial expressions to it. The process is similar to making your normal keyframes, but attaching a shape key keyframe to an action is a little bit janky. I'll show you how to do it though. Start by selecting your character's armature and selecting the action you want to attach shape keys to. Then click on your character model and select the same exact action. You need to do this, otherwise your shape key animations will go to some random action and it'll be a pain to transfer over. With my character's waving animation, I'm going to add a little smile. With the model selected, change the action editor view to the shape key editor view, then enable the auto keyframe button on the timeline. To simulate a smile, I will go to the frame around where she first raises her arm, and I'll look for the brow inner up key, the eye blink keys, and the mouse smile keys, and tweak the values. Go back a few frames before and set each of those keys to 0, so the animation will transition to the smile. Copy the smile keys over to the right before she puts her arm down, and then copy the default keys to a few frames after that. To make sure you did this properly, go back to the action editor view and select your armature. You should see both the armature poses and the shape keys in the same action. That's all there really is to it. It takes some getting used to switching back and forth from the shape key editor, but it gets the job done. Now let's export your character to Godot. What's really cool as well is that your animation with shape keys will export just fine to Godot. When you export your model, toggle the shape key setting under the data setting, assuming you're using the GLTF format like I am. In addition, do not export the shape key normals. Toggling this exports the janky normals that we saw earlier, whereas leaving it unchecked preserves your model's custom normals better. Lastly, make sure the shape key animation setting is checked under the animation settings. Outside of that, your export settings are the same as always. If you need more info on the export process, my last video has a step-by-step guide on it, so feel free to check that out. Once you have your model exported to Godot, you should now see that your model mesh has blend shapes available. While our sliders were 0 to 1 in Blender, they're always negative 1 to 1 in Godot. Just be mindful not to go below 0 or you'll get funky results, as we made them based on 0 to 1. But these can be keyframed in Godot animations like any other property, or you can keyframe them in Blender like we just did. The animation you just made should also have the shape keys keyframes, so test it out and see your hard work pay off. That's pretty much it for this video. Where should we go next? One option is to explore the world of facial mocap. I still have to find ways to do it on a budget and without an iPhone effectively, but I can make some future content on it when I have something. Also, we can further optimize our shape key setup by making a hybrid rig. This will reduce the number of shape keys we need, which will give some performance benefits too. I plan to share this solution once I have it ready. And of course, we can dive even deeper into animation now that you have a model with shape keys. We can look into animation trees and take a peek at my workflow I use for my combat system. Other than that, you're not that far away from having a complete AAA-ready 3D model. The last thing you'll need, of course, is jiggle physics, which I got you covered here if you're interested. Thank you for watching, and as always, have a great day!